life doesn't make any sense without interdependence. We need each other, and the sooner we learn that, the better it will be for us. This is Eric Erickson, the theorist of he has, the one we talked today is about the 8 stages of development for an individual. According to SlideShare.net, published May 26, 2013, Eric Erickson is someone that was focused on society and culture to see how it affects in an individual. I am the youngest of 4, and due to that, I always look up to my brother. So thanks to him, I'm the person I am today, because he's the one that influenced my life the most. So Eric Erickson was born in Frankfurt, Germany. He married Joanne, and he had kids with her. She impacted his life a lot to become a theorist, along with Freud. And these are the 8 stages that we go through, and we not mind to see each stage at the time that it's given. So that's why everyone functions kind of differently, because if you don't succeed here, you have problems here. And so it goes so on and so on, right? By me informing you about his theory, it will help you to understand the importance of the process of development. Now I would like to give you his background. I will talk about his theory and his age, different stages that he has. Like I said, Eric Erickson was a, something like that, but not quite. But his social development, and we must know him as a person first to understand his theory. According to Mike Lee, Life A series, he focused on life as a series of crises, according, of course, at each development, but it's not always achieved at the time given. So with that said, the stages, however, can be resolved successfully at later time. So if you don't succeed it here, you can find it here, and so on and so on. Erickson extends on Freud's thoughts by focusing on the adaptive and creative character, right? So like Freud, he had a lot of impact to Erickson, because Freud focused only on 5 stages. He focused more on the like child. He really didn't focus on like till you hit the older adult kind of thing, you know? So that's what he focused more on, and he see how every development to your growth has an impact on who you are today, and so on. If a person is unable to resolve a conflict at a particular stage, every individual admitted of a comfort and struggle with comfort with later. Okay. So we have stage 1, and we have trust and mistrust, and this is given at birth to beginning 18 months. And if the child doesn't have trust at the beginning, it will suffer later on in life. And sometimes we might not know how to trust the world. So this is an important thing to have at the beginning. Because if your mother doesn't have that bonding with you, it's where you lose trust or you can gain trust. So then second stage, we have when it comes to potty training. When it comes to potty training, you don't have to force a child to use it if he's not sure that he's ready for it. That's why we have, if you force a child, is when he becomes shameful and has doubt in himself. So it's really important to go at the child's pace and really be aware of where the child falls into, because if you don't let him succeed in this stage, he will have more trouble later on in stage 3. Stage 3 is, can I make it in the world of people and things? So this is more, and we can talk about more in elementary. So this is where bullying comes along too. Like if you bully people, it's when they can start feeling guilt because they don't feel that they're enough for the world. And then this is where you get the idea, right? Bullying, and stage 4 is stage 4 rehab, is it okay for me to do the things I do? Same thing, you know, if you don't succeed in none of these, you have trouble with the other stages, and every stage is important to individual's growth. This is one of my favorite ones, stage 5, who am I? This is very important because this is where we make our life decisions, whether you know who you are or what do you want to be. So it's really important to know who you are to have more understanding on how to develop your other stages. Stage 6, can I love? This is a very important thing, and something that I would want to share for stage 6 is when people refer like, oh, I hate love, love is not for me. It's because they haven't found the intimacy with that one person, or their household wasn't a level place to be in. And stage 7, can I make my life count? So this is when you're already on your like 40s, right there when you get married, you know. Most people start getting married, they're building a family, and then that's where that comes along. And then the last stage, is it okay to be what I have been? Well, you're dead, you know, we're not dead yet, but you're still, you're elder, and you're going to die pretty soon, you know, I don't know. So it's, you come to reflect, did I make a change in this world? You know, like, how did I impact people, you know? So now that I have talked about, like, the stages and like the importance of them, I will now, now that I have described his 8 stages of life, of development, and how it can impact us from a very young age, let's wrap things up. It is important to inform yourself completely about the stages of development for a better understanding of human growth. Let me summarize. I first talked about Erickson's background a little bit. Second, I mentioned his interests. And finally, I developed his development of the 8 stages. Erickson was a philosopher. Stages have a focus based on the development crisis of an individual social stand. And I just wanted to leave with something that I came up with when I was doing this research. It is from a young age that our future is put into destiny. Every young life impacts our life.